You're broke. You need money. You don't know where to get money. You don't have any loans. You don't have any credit cards. You don't have any cash. In some cases, you may be just one step away from homeless. What is the best business model for you to start making cash come in ASAP? I'm talking about you work today, you get money today. Well, my friends, that is called a service business. Now, a service business can be very powerful if you understand what you're getting yourself into. There are many people that will shun service businesses. It's dirty. You're not doing something glamorous. To you, my dear friends, who need money, how can you be choosy? That's something that's a little perplexing. I can't answer that question for you, but you will have to answer that question. But for those who are here who want to learn how to make money as quick as possible, and to have a pathway to more profitability and going from part-time to full-time to business owner, and I'll break all that down. The first thing that we need to address is income. In America, the average single person income is between $28,000 and $32,000 per year. Average means half of America makes that or less. Half of America makes that or more. Now, why is this important? When you begin your service business, you're going to have to filter out a ton of information. You'll go on Facebook, you'll go on the internet, and you'll see that there's this 17-year-old kid or this 22-year-old single mom that 6 months ago was living in dire straits, and now he or she is making $10,000 to $20,000 to $30,000 a month. And here you are with your service business only making an extra $300 to maybe $1,500 per month. You feel like a failure. You feel like, I'm wasting my time. I must be doing something wrong. And then you begin to start searching out the remedy, the secrets. You've been looking for the gurus, right? The reason that I'm giving you this information is to properly shape perspectives. If your perspective isn't properly shaped, you're going to fall prey to what I like to call hustler porn. And it's not healthy. And many of these people are just straight up lying to you. Now that you've been properly formatted, you will need a few things for you to see the money. First of all, you need the 5 checking account blueprint and a budget. You need to handle the money that you're currently making to the best of your ability. Then start making more money. Once you have the budget, once you have the 5 checking accounts, then when money starts to come in, you can actually see it. It isn't absorbed by your lifestyle or pent up demand. How many times have you gotten a sum of money, $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $10,000, and then you start thinking of all the stuff that you can get, or maybe the overdue bills that you have to pay. And before you know it, that money's gone. You never had a budget. You didn't have the 5 checking account blueprint. So you just did what most Americans do. You lived and you spent. It's very important for you to get a handle on your personal finances before you begin bringing in business income. If you don't do that, it's not going to end well. Now let's get to the service business. Before you start looking for a business model or asking questions, yo, Glendon, hey man, is auto detailing a good business? You are looking in the wrong places. The first thing you should do is ask yourself a few questions. What type of people do I like serving? I know that sounds strange. It's like, hey, Glendon, I just want this money. I don't care about all that, but you should. You should ask yourself, who do you like to serve? What is fun for you? What is creative? What do you like to do? That's where you need to start. You don't need to listen to Hustler 786 on the internets. You don't need to listen to the single mom who's saying, hey, sell these bird's eggs or whatever they're doing. You don't need to listen to that. You need to listen to yourself, because you know yourself better than anyone else does. Because here in America, and I'm going to wave the flag, you can do whatever you want to. And that is a freedom that many people just take for granted. Oh, I can do whatever I want to. What good is that? Once again, perspective. If you're living in one of these countries where if you say the wrong thing, do the wrong thing, they chop your head off, these freedoms are very real. And this is why immigrants who come here do better than Native Americans. It's not because they get special loans. It's not because of set-aside programs. They know what's waiting for them back home. I can't do what I can do here in America back home. That's why I'm over here. Matter of fact, many immigrants will work here and send money back home to their family. And many people have misplaced anger because the immigrants have an organic perspective that you just don't. Many, and you're going to hate me, are entitled. You feel entitled to the American dream. You feel entitled to having a house. You feel entitled to having a nice car. And this is how the credit industry sucks you in. If you got rid of that entitlement and start to say, okay, how do I want to live my life? Things get a little interesting. Things get a little different. You looking for a marketplace or an audience that aligns with who you are. Online, you'll hear many people who will spend 10, 20, 15, 30 grand for a mastermind or a program about this one thing. And they'll get in there and they're just not successful. It's because they never wanted to do that thing to begin with. They just went after it for the money. And trust me on this, do not do it for the money. Trust me on this. Go ahead and find a group of people that you like serving. I like serving the money, income, and profit community. I like the people. I like the enthusiasm. I like the energy. I like being around hustlers. So this isn't hard for me to do. It isn't hard for me to show up. It's hard for me to rally. But if you find yourself dragging to go do this hustle or side business, that's kind of like having a job that you hate. Why would you create a job for yourself that you hate? That makes no sense. Now that we found the marketplace audience you like serving, you got to do some research. I know it's on the internet, it's on YouTube. You really need to start going to Google or Bing and start looking up stats and data about that particular audience. Your first question should be, how big is this market? Your second question, is this market growing or dying? I'll give you some insights to what I'm doing. Money, income, and profit is geared for what I feel the coming wave of people shifting from jobs to freelancing and self-employment. It's coming. I don't know when it's going to get here, but it's coming. And this great book, Harvey McKay, Dig Your Well Before You're Thirsty, the time to start setting up for that audience is before they start growing. Because once that audience is established, once people are like, yeah, that's a big audience, then the sharks will come. Well, I can tell you from this channel's first few years, 2009 to about 2013, I was a storage auction dude. I talked about storage auctions. I wrote a book. I had a Craigslist book. I dominated simply because I was first. Yes, I made mistakes. I also left money on the table. But by the time all these other sharks came in, the market was starting to die. And this is why it's very important for you to ask yourself, is this marketplace big? How big it is? And is it growing or dying? Now, whether it's growing or dying, you can still make money, but your orientation should be, I'm going to treat this market that is dying as a trend, and I'm going to try to get as much money out of it as possible before it goes away or just gets to a niche market. Because you can make money with niche markets, you can make money with mass markets. But if you're getting into something special or esoteric and the marketplace is dying, it's going to be very hard to make consistent money. Now, if you get into a market that is growing, oh, baby. When I wrote my storage auction book, the market was extremely small. There wasn't many people that knew about storage auctions, and the people who did were very tight-lipped about it. Then the television shows came on. And then all of a sudden, it started raining money because for about 2 years, when someone came to the Google machine and looked up storage auctions, they found this guy. So don't get caught up into chasing established markets. And once again, we'll talk about another video about that. But you can make money with established markets. You just got to be better or different or have some weird quirk about you that you can make it in that market. You know what the market is. You like the market. It's growing. Now, this is the hardest part. You got to take action every day. Every day. I'm going to give you a synopsis of what happened to me with my Craigslist marketing. Just speed up the story. We were what I like to call eBay top heavy, and eBay just suspended our account, and we were getting 75% of our income from eBay. Scary times. And this is where Craigslist came in. We were already selling on Craigslist and we were making good money, but we were just selling furniture, washer and dryers. We weren't selling esoterics. But I knew there was a massive market on Craigslist and it was growing. This was around 2001, 2002. The market wasn't established. They were just like originated in San Francisco and it was still growing and filtering around. And I believe at one time that Craigslist was in the top 10 of the most trafficked websites in the world. So I just went crazy and I started establishing protocols and systems to market on Craigslist. And week after week after week, our revenues grew. But it was a growing market. There was plenty of money. This is why you want to do your own research, because I know you believe that everything is on the internet, but I'm here to tell you that when someone is making money in a growing market, they're not really telling a lot of people what's going on. And that's really it. Because I know many of you will ask me about, like, what kind of service business should I get into? I don't know. I don't know you. I don't know your work ethic. I don't know what you want, what you like. I have no clue. I have no clue what your goals are. Nothing. Once again, when I did this Craigslist thing, very few people knew about it, and that's one of the reasons it was so profitable. And I said in my earlier videos that if I had not exited the storage auction business, I never would have wrote the storage auction book. I never wrote the Craigslist book, because those were my best trade secrets, and they still work to this day. So that's all I have for you guys. If you want to accelerate your income, go below and I have a few things for you. The first thing, for the folks who don't have a lot of money, but who I guess this video is really targeting, get the 100 hours of training for Craigslist, eBay, well, not Craigslist, not eBay, Craigslist, YouTube, many types of beginning side businesses. This will get your toes wet, you won't spend a lot of money, and you'll get a ton of information and a lot of stuff to go through. The second thing, for those who want even more, I'm going to start selling H undergrad static. Now, what does that mean? This is not the monthly membership program. It's will be a membership. You can pay whatever price I'll dictate. I'll put it down below. And you can get these 23 additional courses. This is not the same as the Side Hustle Starter Pack. This is something totally different. So I'll put those on a special for people who need help and don't have a lot of money. Then for folks who want the esoteric stuff, the Art of Holding, that's going to cost you a grip. And for people who pay in full for the H undergrad program, this is what I'm going to do. You go ahead and you drop the $2,500. Then what we're going to do is add you to everything at moneyincomeandprofit.com. And then you get 1 year. You don't get this forever and ever, but you get 1 year of the online classes. So they'll be yours to keep forever and ever. And that's for the folks who spend their grip. And the same thing for the Art of Holding. You spend the $2,900. Once again, you get everything. And you get the online classes at moneyincomeandprofit.com. And online classes are live or current webinars. It'll be current training or live webinars. It'll be either one, just depending upon the schedule. So all of that's below, and I'll see you guys in the next video.
We'll be right back.